I feel like I kind of look like Max Da Silva a little bit, and all of you know who he is because all of you subscribe to his channel. I feel like and totally, isn't he rocking the bald look? I mean, man, Max Da Silva, a guy who's in his early 20s, less hair on top, but man, I just love to see him in his journey and his confidence as he's really owning this whole shaved head look. What is this video about? Oh, right. Okay. So, look, here's what's happened since I did this 4 weeks ago. I've been maintaining basically the zero guard since then. The number of views on each video has, all my new videos have tripled. So any video I make now will make triple the views that it would have had I still had hair. And because of that, a lot of comments come through and I can barely keep up with them all. But I know that I saw one recently talking about, I think it was in the video I made saying, what purpose does having hair even serve in 2018? Now that, you know, it's a sign of masculinity and sexiness and looking taller and more in charge. If you choose to get rid of hair, or if you have no hair, that's a good thing and that's how society perceives it. What's the point of having hair? And one of the comments I remember seeing pass through was someone saying that basically having hair just actually makes you have confidence issues. So I want to unpack that for a moment. Let's think about this from the opposite perspective. I know that the concept is so many people show up on my channel because they're feeling insecure, because they're seeing signs of hair loss. And the solution in so many people's minds is, man, if only I could stop losing my hair or reverse my hair loss, then I could be a more confident person. Okay? But it's funny because when you deconstruct that, it's almost like what I'm hearing right now is someone saying, I have hair that I'm afraid that I'm going to completely lose, therefore I'm insecure. Okay? So what if having hair is the thing that causes the insecurity? And I feel like I've provided plenty of proof in my videos since I've buzzed off all my hair that I've given reason for so many of you to actually buzz off your hair. I never asked you to, you know, but so many of you just started doing it and admitting that life is better when you choose not to have hair. So it's interesting, such a paradox, that what if instead of hair loss being the problem, the fact hair in general is the problem, that men don't need hair, they're better off without hair. And when they get rid of it, their confidence increases. I mean, is that even a theory at this point? I feel like that's the main takeaway of this channel at this point, is that people come here worrying they might lose their hair and it causes them to have confidence issues. And then I meet them like, hi, even though I could still have hair, I choose not to have hair and I'm better off for it. So you could do the same and you could become like me. Like, isn't that funny that so many people, so many guys in the world are worried about their hair loss, and yet if they got rid of the hair, they wouldn't have the problem anymore and they'd have more confidence. But so many guys can't do that. They say, oh no, and they'll give a reason why they can't buzz off their hair. Maybe they don't have the right head shape. We get that one a lot. But what it really reminds me of, and I know I've mentioned this recently, but it really reminds me of the fact I've been a vegan for over 5 years, and people have been so brainwashed to believe that they have to get their protein from animals that they can't be open-minded enough to be like Nick Schell and eat just vegetables, fruits, beans, grains, nuts, and seeds for over 5 years and actually be healthier and not have sinus issues anymore, not have pet allergies, and not have dysidrotic eczema anymore. But it's funny, people are closed-minded to that fact. They're like, no, but you got to get protein from animals. No, but how do you get your protein? Even today when I was doing my work as a freelance social media guy, because I get paid to do that now, I kind of have a new job going. And when I was doing a little thing with like Hormel or Oscar Mayer or whatever, it's like the ad said, now you don't have to worry about where to get your protein from. And it was like this little snack bag with like almonds, cheese, and turkey. And then it had the guy's hand, and he's like munching on almonds, cheese, and turkey. And I'm thinking, you know what's funny about that? I'm a vegan, and I never worry about where I'm gonna get enough protein. So isn't that ironic that someone who eats cheese and meat would worry, where am I gonna get enough protein? I gotta get enough protein. Where's my protein gonna come from? The guy who eats the meat and cheese and eggs is worried about where he's gonna get his protein. Meanwhile, the vegan of 5 years who used to have health problems and no longer has them never worries about where he's gonna get his protein from. Can you imagine? That's laughable, isn't it? A vegan never worries about where he's gonna get protein because he already knows. Vegetables, fruits, beans, grains, nuts, seeds. And then the people who eat animal products worry, where am I getting enough protein? Isn't that funny and ironic? And isn't it pretty much the same exact thing as the guys who worry about their hair loss when they still have hair, but maybe their hairline's starting to go up or change or mature or whatever it is, and they're freaking out about it and it's destroying their self-confidence. While other guys the same age as those guys, whether they're in their teens or 20s or 30s or whatever age other guys are, they have less hair and shaved it off, and they have more confidence. Isn't that the exact same thing as the guy who eats meat and cheese and eggs saying, where am I gonna get my protein, compared to Nick Schell who says, I never worry or wonder where I'm gonna get my protein. To me, it's the exact same thing. I really want you to analyze what I've said today. Put it in the comments. What do you think about this? It's the whole concept of people put so much stock in these things that don't matter. And the moment you take the thing away, you realize life is a lot better without the thing that you never needed to begin with.